Hello, hello. KennyCEvans here, another car video. Topic of this video is why a woman's count does not matter. Doesn't matter. So, before I get into this, like the video if you want to just support, help the algorithm. But of course, subscribe. I appreciate subscriptions. Getting a little warm. And hit that notification button for whenever I make other videos, you'll be notified. So, now let's get back into this topic. Why a woman's body count doesn't matter. This is a very controversial topic when it comes to dating relationships. And some people say it will determine how you treat a woman. So you can't turn a hoe into a housewife, and you know, all these women have all these options, and that's why they so picky, because they sleeping around with the Chads and Tyrones, alpha male, select man, strong man, confident man, you know, whatever, high value man, they picking all of them. So the rest of us, rest of y'all don't have any chance, you know, so I'm going to tell you how come it doesn't matter and how come you shouldn't worry about it. First and foremost, a woman's past should not determine her present and is not her present. She could have been a hoe going through that whole phase in her past, but now she's ready to be married and she's reformed herself. You shouldn't hold it against her. She is definitely not the same person. You know? And what if people decided to hold your past against you? All the mistakes, all the bad decisions, all your growing pains. All that stuff was held against you. Your lack of knowledge, your lack of experience. So what makes you think you have the right to hold, or you should hold, a woman's past against her? Bam. So, number two, as you know, she could change. Again, just because she may have had a promiscuous past, it doesn't mean she couldn't be a faithful woman. Maybe the likelihood of it happening consistently could be low. But it still could happen. Of course, you definitely want to keep in mind little details she might have told about her past, maybe about her relationship with her father, if she's cheated on different, every guy she's been with or different men that she's been with. But ultimately, it's not set in stone. Because she still could change. But again, you just keep it in mind. You know what I mean? But when it comes to the body count, she could change. So always keep that in mind. She may have had a million guys before you, but you could be the last one. But yes, next, how well does she treat you? If she treats you very well, she makes you happy, what does it matter if she slept with a million guys? What does it matter? Yeah. What does it matter? Because if she treats you well, that's all that's important. After this, the next point is, how well does she follow your lead? It if she's following your lead, she's submissive to you, she's obedient to you. Again, what does it matter how many men she slept with if she's making your life easier, better, and more fun? What does it matter? I mean, it's just like, it's ridiculous, the superficial things that we worried about. How many men a woman has slept with, but yet she is the perfect citizen for you, the perfect employee. All that stuff that you never saw, never had to deal with, you're going to hold that against her. But when you are dealing with her, she's perfect. Or she's, you know, very good to you. I don't get it. I don't get it. I still don't understand how, what it matters. Yeah. Of course, the next point is, did you train her to become the woman you want? Of course, that's a very big deal. If she's open to becoming the woman you want and she's receptive to the training, there you go. You got yourself a winner. But if she's not, there you go. You got yourself someone who's got to be replaced. But the body count has nothing to do with that. Her body count has nothing to do with that at all. That is not something you got to worry about when it comes to that. Because her becoming your ideal woman will negate all that. Because she'll add more value than she'll subtract. So you just got to keep that in mind. You got to always keep that in mind. You know, and again, this goes with her following your lead. She's following your lead. There you go. What's the problem? You know, you trained her to do what you want and be act how you want. Ride with that horse. Metaphorically speaking, of course. But last but not least, her body count really just doesn't matter. You don't have to ask her body count because her actions will speak louder than her words. You'll be able to tell if she's a promiscuous woman. If you're good at reading women, you'll be able to tell how she may be looking at other guys while she's with you. You know, how she may be a little bit secretive with her phone. You know what I mean? How she hasn't had any real long-term relationships. You know, you'll be able to tell whether she's has a high body count or not. But again, it doesn't matter if she's open to your training and if she treats you well. Yeah. You know? But you'll be able to tell if she's a little bit more promiscuous. You know, I know, here's a little bonus. K Zagan, Mr. Lucario, they talk about even virgins suck dick. And in order to preserve their virginity, they'll do anal sex. You know, so just because a woman may have a quote unquote low body count, it doesn't mean they ain't out here getting it in. Maybe not with the pussy, but in other areas. You know what I mean? And even with that, you still gotta see how she treats you and if she's willing to play by your rules. You know, so whether a woman is truthful about her body count and she truly has a high body count, or if she's lying, it just doesn't matter. How well does she play by your rules? and open to your game plan. That's all that really matters. You know, and pair bonding doesn't matter because that doesn't have anything to do with body count. It's all about how she was treated by those men and how she treated those men that she dealt with. You know, so always keep that in mind. Women's body count don't matter. But I appreciate y'all watching this video with me. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know whether you agree, disagree. Let me know, of course, what other comments or topics you want me to talk about. Found value in this video. I appreciate donations. And, yo, stay safe till next week. I'll see y'all then. And always remember, the strongest man is the happiest man. Peace.